All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Stuart Boucher, the CFO of Decibel Cannabis. And Stuart, it's nice to see you. How are you?
Doing well. Thanks, Steve. How are you?
I'm doing very, very well. Thank you. And excited to learn a little bit more about the company. I know you had some news out. We'll talk about that in a couple of minutes. But the interesting part of the company is sort of the beginning of the company. So why don't you sort of take us to where it all started to where you are today?
Sure. And so I really love to go back to the roots of the business where it really came to fruition in 2019. So you had two different companies that merged to form Decibel. And so one called WeGrow BC. And so what WeGrow carried with it was very high quality brand, very high quality products, and underpinned by a deep genetics portfolio. So it really brings with it the roots of BC Bud, and it's based in Creston, BC. What was lacking was really the growth behind it. And so additional infrastructure and scale to build a larger platform. The other company within that merger was a business called Westleaf. And so what Westleaf brought was infrastructure in a large scale cultivation facility designed with similar growth methodology to WeGrow. So it allowed to expand capacity by about four times, a 2.0 extraction lab. So allowed us to bring the business into the 2.0 category, which is a fast growing segment. And then at the same time, a retail portfolio, which we needed to ultimately figure out how to best utilize. And so from that, Decibel was formed. We put together a strategic position in which we are competing as the premium producer in the cannabis segment under our Quest brand, which WeGrow BC brought, expanding that into the 2.0 segment. Particularly concentrates and vapes. And so all of those categories have a unique position where they're dictated by high quality genetics. So we're focusing on what we're best at and bringing that into market. In addition to that, we leverage our retail stores, which provide a great access point to consumers. So you think about how LPs work today. It's very much focused on getting products into market and kind of guessing as to what the consumer wants. And so we use our retail stores, bit of like an R&D facility. So we have a great platform. We have 25,000 customers. And so we're able to bring those products into the market in small formats, see how consumers respond, and then ultimately reposition the product, launch it nationwide, and create a ton of success. So that's really how the core of the business was built. And then speaking to a bit of the growth trajectory. So in 2021, we set two targets. One, ramping up our Thunderchild facility and getting it into run rate production. So that's going from 1,800 kilograms of production at the start of the year to 9,200 kilograms by the end of the year.
So Stuart, it's interesting how you're able to use your retail stores, as you mentioned, as sort of R&D and almost like a testing lab to see how things go. Let's talk a bit about growth. Where do you see the biggest growth coming for the company?
Yeah, so I think we have four key growth drivers, and some of which are short term, coming in Q4, and then some of which are into 2022. So if you look at the targets we set out this year, we have two. So that's launching a number of 2.0 products, concentrates and vapes from the Quest brand into market. And so that's focusing on a premiumization strategy where we're taking a highly reputable flower brand and bringing that into concentrates and vapes. So we're nearing completion of that. And we just announced another 13 products coming into market, six of which are associated with Quest. The second part is ramping up the supply of Quest flower. So historically, it's been extremely supply constrained. We have tremendous demand in market and are constantly out of stock as a result. And so we've been limiting our assortment in the various provinces. So what you can think about is if we have five different flavors, we only have two in Ontario. So recently, we just announced that we're going to have the full suite in Ontario for the first time. And we're going to be doing the same in Western Canada as we roll out those products. So that's the key growth driver where we're going from 1,800 kilograms to 9,200 kilograms by the end of this year, where we have relatively high degree of certainty that there's demand because we've been restricting our supply. The third is really our growth pipeline for 2022. So we're always focused on innovation, driving new product formats, taking from the US, as well as what we're able to create with a very dedicated and creative team. And we're leveraging our retail assets to get that understanding for what consumers are looking for. And then lastly, with our recent capital raise, we have a number of growth initiatives through capital investment. And so that's less focused on revenue, but more focused on cost structure. So if you think about how Decibel has created our products, we're very focused on an MVP type product. So we're talking a prototype that we bring to our retail stores, create demand around, and then launch nationwide. We try to do that with very little capital investment up front. So it's very labor intensive, very little equipment, and again, higher cost to begin with, but that creates investment opportunities longer term. As we create that demand, we can invest around these products to make them more, more profitable.
So you also had a, you mentioned the financing itself, and maybe you can tell me a bit about that one. And specifically, you had some big players coming in as that as well, that are, I guess are starting to understand the story and where you're headed.
Yeah, for sure. So it was an incredibly successful financing. So a large amount of institutional participation, as well as some retail support, tremendous amount of long only funds focused on our business, seeing the fundamentals. And then those use of proceeds are going to be spent on very high return on capital projects. So about 50% of those use of proceeds are going to three projects. As I mentioned, again, focusing on cost structure. So a processing hub at our extraction facility. The second portion is a butane extraction at our extraction facility. And so we think we can drastically expand gross margins as we continue to internalize all of our processes and stop passing margin along to third party producers. And then in addition to that, we have a tissue culture lab coupled with infrastructure investments. And so these are really maximizing the efficiency of our cultivation. So it contributes to higher yields. It contributes to more consistency and quality product, which we're always gonna focus on investing in. And then it's creating long-term competitive advantages within our business. So if you think about recreational cannabis, it's undifferentiated, but with our tissue culture lab, one process we can do is called protoplast fusion. It allows you to create new genetics to which we can create legal protection through IP and breeders' rights. So that allows us to create products that other producers can't carry and is unique to Decibel and Quest brand. So that's where we see ourselves going. And these projects are going to be complete in early 2022.
Wow. Well, it sounds one thing for sure, Stuart. It is busy. That's for sure. You got a lot of stuff going on. Thanks very much for the time. Appreciate you spending some minutes with us to learn a bit more about the company. And I know we're going to talk again soon. So great to see you. Thanks very much. Congratulations on the financing.
Thank you, Steve. Thanks for having us on.
All right. There's Stuart Boucher. He's the CFO of Decibel Cannabis.